Eagle watch in Pittsburgh's Hayes neighborhood. The family of four bald eagles could soon be a family of five. Mom and dad are waiting for their third egg to hatch.
This is super cool. The live streaming camera shows every move, night and day. Pittsburgh's Action News 4 reporter Shannon Perrine tonight on just how long it's been since eagles soared above Pittsburgh. Shannon?
It's been a while. If you start watching this video, I have to warn you, it's hard to stop. Now, we know that the American bald eagle used to be on the endangered species list, right? And thankfully, that has changed. We also know Pittsburgh was an important link on the American Rust Belt. Well, industry pushed the eagle's food supply out of our three rivers more than two centuries ago. The State Game Commission says it's been 250 years since eagles nested along Pittsburgh's three rivers. Now they're back. This is a shot of mom feeding the two eaglets today.
They're just a majestic bird, very, you know, very beautiful.
From the ground, eagle fans look up at the nest and the show mother and father put on, showing off a wingspan that can stretch more than 7 feet. But what about the birds' perspective? Today's eagles can catch an inning or two at PNC Park and count the skyscrapers downtown. This is the first time this species has seen our city since 1764. The ancestors of this young eagle family in Hayes would have seen Pittsburgh like this, perhaps watching in horror at the siege of Pittsburgh in 1763 and the construction of Fort Pitt from high above. The last time eagles soared above the three rivers was the same year the blockhouse was built, just outside of Fort Pitt at the Point. While industry grew up around the blockhouse, it killed just about every kind of fish the bald eagle would snatch out of the Allegheny, the Monongahela, and the Ohio rivers. So the symbol of America defected to Canada for a while. Now that their food has returned, the birds can too.
These eagles catch a lot of fish. We see them flying fish around. You know, that just shows how, you know, the environment is coming around.
I think it speaks to the improvement in the ecosystem and the way that we can use our rivers now and our trails and the health of the rivers and the health of the entire area.
The species hasn't changed, but the city has. Pittsburgh's population in 1764, about 300. Today, about 300,000. That many more eyes on the ground watching Pittsburgh's newest residents high above. I'm Shannon Perrine, Pittsburgh's Action News 4.
That is absolutely beautiful.